Now we will discuss about the theories of failure which are used for ductile materials. These are also known as yield criteria because we are using yield point stress as the limiting value, that is the maximum value for these materials. As we already discussed, we study three theories under this. One is maximum shear stress theory, and then we have distortion energy theory, and the third one is ductile Coulomb Mohr theory. So these three theories will be used for ductile materials, and the theories of failures are also known by the name yield criteria. The first one is maximum shearing stress theory. According to this theory, the parameter that is to be used is maximum shear stress. So tau max should be the parameter that is used or that is measured to tell whether a component are failed or not. So the definition of the theory is failure, that is in this case yielding, occurs whenever the maximum shearing stress in any point in the component equals or exceeds the maximum shearing stress value observed in the tensile test of the specimen when that specimen begins to yield. So basically means, so once you should know, there are two things. One is we should know what is the tau max at yield. So when a tensile test specimen of that particular component fails, okay, at the time of failure, we should know what is the maximum shear stress that a component or that material can bear. Once we know the maximum shear stress at that yield, this can be called as your strength of the material. So according to this theory, strength is nothing but maximum shear stress that exists in the material at the time of failure. So this should be compared with the maximum shear stress developed at any point in your component. Okay, that's a basic idea. So the tau max, this left hand side represent the maximum stress developed in a particular point or a given point where we want to know whether it has failed or not. Whereas this RHS represent tau max at yield, which is nothing but the strength of the material. Now let us find out how to find the tau max. So as we already discussed, tau max, that is maximum shear stress, can be found out from the principal stresses, normal, that is maximum principal stresses. We know we have three principal stresses, sigma 1, sigma 2 and sigma 3. Using these three normal stresses, we can find the maximum shear stresses. So when I say maximum shear stress, they are basically extremum values. So one will be maximum, one will be minimum, and the other one will be in between these two. So once we know the maximum normal stresses, so we'll use the formulas for first shear stress given by this equation, sigma 2 minus sigma 3 by 2. And second shear stress is found out from this equation, and third shear stress is found out from this equation. Okay, once we calculate this, sigma 2 minus sigma 3 by 2, sigma 3 minus sigma 1 by 2, sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, so we'll get three values. Among these three values, you have to get the maximum value. So that will become the tau max. So this is the maximum shear stress developed at the point of interest where you want to find out whether the material has failed or not. This has to be compared with the strength of the material. Strength in this theory is tau max at yield. Okay. So let us see how to find out the RHS, that is the maximum value of shear stress at yielding or at that point of failure. So when we do the shear test. So here, ideally we should go for shear test. Okay. The strength tau max at yield is available when the material starts yielding in shear, that value should be used for the theory or for calculation in according to this theory. However, if this value is not available, we can indirectly obtain the tau max at yield from the simple tensile test also. Okay, preferably you should use the shear test. If it is not available, then you should go for simple tensile test. So we can also get the tau max at yield from the it is possible to find tau max at yield from the simple tensile test also. So if you remember, the state of stress at the point of failure is given by the value sigma 1 is equal to sigma yield point, sigma 2 is equal to 0, sigma 3 is equal to 0. So when you substitute these values in the maximum shear stress equation here, in this equation, sigma 2, sigma 3 are 0, the first value is 0, and sigma 3 minus sigma 1 if we get 0 minus sigma yb by 2, this is again this value, and third one will be sigma yb. So the maximum among them will be sigma yp by 2. So this is the indirectly we are obtaining the tau max at yield as sigma yp by 2. Remember, this tau max at yield is the maximum shear stress at the point of failure, whereas sigma yp is the yield point, at normal stress, which is producing the yield stress. Yield point is for the normal stress. Okay. So now we will find out. We can rewrite the equation as below. So the LHS is this portion. In general, maximum shear stress theory can be written this way. So we this is tau 1, tau 2, tau 3 found out from the individual principal plane stresses. And then this is tau max at yield. Tau max at yield. So if it is directly not available, then we can find out from indirectly from the sigma yp value. So when you substitute here, we get 2 gets cancelled. We'll have maximum of this sigma 1 minus sigma 2, or sigma 2 minus sigma 3, or sigma 3 minus sigma 1. So you have to compute these differences, and the maximum among them should be compared with the sigma yp. So that is the condition for failure in maximum shear stress theory. Of course, if this value is greater than sigma yp, then failure has occurred. So now we'll write what is the design equation. Now let's imagine yield point of the material is, let us say, 300 megapascal. We don't actually design a component for 300 megapascal because we use a certain factor of safety. Let us say we want to use a factor of safety of 2. Okay, so that makes sigma yp by 2 is equal to 150. So we design for 150 MPa instead of 300 MPa because we want to take care of the uncertainties in terms of loads and strength of the material. So the number 2 is known as factor of safety. So this will reduce the strength by number 2, and we'll get the design. This is a working, that is a design stress that is to be used in the calculation. So therefore, so sigma yp by n is written. So this n is factor of safety. Then the equation becomes design equation for the maximum shear stress theory. So this can equations can be used for 3D case, in general 3D case. Of course, a 2D is a special case of 3D. Now we will study some special cases of this. Suppose, as we discussed already, we don't want to find out each shear stress and then compare. What we can do instead is, we first arrange stresses in the form of sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. So whatever stresses you get, you may get 3 values. Number 1, number 2, you will get 3 values from the equation, cubic equation. And you have to arrange these values in such a fashion that they are in decreasing order. Okay. And then once you arrange, the maximum value is given a name sigma 1, and the minimum value is given a name sigma 3. So therefore, we can directly compute sigma 1 minus sigma 3 is equal to sigma yp. So the maximum shear stress theory can be written as sigma 1 minus sigma 3 is equal to sigma yp. So this is relatively simpler. Or if you want to convert into design equations, you divide by factor of safety n. Okay, and then you already discussed. So let's now we'll discuss how to get the plot of maximum shear stress theory. So when I say plot, it basically means what is the maximum value of sigma A and sigma B that a component can have so that it won't fail according to this theory. Here, if you remember, we have used this equation to find out, especially the plot is for 2D case. 2D means the loading is something like this. You have a cube. You applied only sigma x, sigma y, and tau x is applied. So when a loading is this nature, that is 2D in nature, so we can use the equation given by this particular box. Okay, there are two principal stresses within the plane denoted by sigma a and sigma b. There is one plane stress perpendicular to this plane, which is sigma c, which is always equal to 0 for 2D case. Now we want to know what are the maximum values that sigma a and sigma b can take. So when you do that, when you plot that, you will get a plot for maximum shear stress. So it's a graphical plot of sigma a versus sigma b. So let us get into the details now. As you can see from this equation, so there are two possibilities. The when you solve the equation, the first, let me call this as sigma a, the second value, let me call this as sigma b. Okay, it is possible that the first value may be greater than the second value. So that is the first case, first major case, that is sigma a, that is first value will be greater than the second value. Or it may so happen that second value may be greater than the first value. Okay, so these are the two possible scenarios that we get from solving these equations. Now we should also remember there is another principal stress, which is out of plane principal stress, whose value is equal to 0. And we are, as we discussed already, this 0 cannot be neglected. So let us go into detail. So case 1, when you solve the equation, that is sigma a comma b is equal to this entire equation, you get the first value as sigma a and second value as sigma b. So in first scenario, sigma a is greater than b. Okay. In second scenario, sigma b is greater than sigma a. Let's get into further sub cases in case 1. So when sigma is greater than sigma b, so it is possible that both sigma a and sigma b positive, that means both will be tensile values. Okay, then they will be greater than 0. So you can say sigma a and sigma b both are greater than 0. So second possibility is sigma is of course greater than sigma b, but it may so happen sigma a may be positive and sigma b may be negative. In that case, 0 will come in between. So sigma a is greater than 0 is greater than sigma b. And third possibility is both the values sigma a and sigma b computed from the above equations may be compressive. Therefore, they will have a negative values. So naturally, they will be lesser than 0. So there are three subcategories. So okay, even though sigma a is greater than sigma b, still they are compared with 0 to arrange in a particular order. So maximum, middle value and minimum. Similarly, for the second scenario, we have got sigma b is greater than sigma a, and again, it is possible that these values are both tensile, are both compressive, or one may be tensile and one may be compressive. So let us see how this place turns out in case of graphical plot. So in first case, as you can see from this case 1, we have got sigma a is greater than sigma b is greater than 0. So when the stresses are of this nature, okay, let me take an example. Let's say we have got a say 50 is greater than 30 is greater than 0. So the values that we got from solving the above equation was 50 and 30, and obviously that is greater than 0. So now when we arrange them, we'll get this particular thing. So whenever we have a case 1, so let me rewrite case 1. So maximum shear stress is given by sigma 1 minus sigma 3. Okay. So in that case, tau max, okay, let me say tau max is given by sigma 1 minus sigma 3 by 2. Or in other words, this 2 will not come because we can directly write tau max is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 2. Okay, now tau max is, in this case is, if you look at this equation, sigma a is, sigma 1 is sigma a, sigma 1 minus sigma 2 is equal to tau max. So the maximum shear stress equation for the case 1 will be sigma 1 minus sigma 3 is equal to sigma yield point. Now in this case, sigma 1 is nothing but sigma a and sigma 3 is nothing but 0. Okay, so that is equal to sigma yp or yield point. In this diagram, we have written as sy. So therefore, this equation will become sigma a is equal to sigma yp. This is nothing but equation of a straight line. Okay, so this first line represent sigma a is equal to sigma yp. Now let us go to the second case. In second case, we have sigma a is greater than 0 is greater than sigma b. So in this case, this will be sigma 1 and this will be sigma 3. So again, using a maximum shear stress theory, sigma 1 minus sigma 3 is equal to sigma yield point can be written as, so sigma 1 I'll replace with sigma a minus sigma 3 is now sigma b. Sigma b is equal to sigma yp. Now this will be again equation of straight line, but now we will write slightly modified way. Let me write sigma b is equal to sigma a minus sigma yp. Sigma yp. Now we can write this as an equation of straight line. This is y is equal to mx plus c. Now here the value is 1, that is slope value is equal to 1, and as you can see the horizontal length from here to here, that is dx, is sy. Sy is nothing but sigma yield point, and vertical length is also is equal to, this vertical length is also equal to sigma yp. So sigma yp, sigma yp. So the slope of this particular line will be, that is dy by dx is equal to sy by sy, that is 1. The slope is 1. So this represents second line, and also you can verify that that c, that is intercept of the y-axis, is minus sigma yp. So if you can see this, the value is here, it is minus sigma yp. So therefore this particular line, second line, represent this equation. Similarly, we can go to the third case. In third case, we have 0, let me, 0 sorry sig 0 greater than So in the third case, we have 0 greater than sigma a greater than sigma b. So here 0 represents the sigma 1 and sigma b represents sigma 3. So the maximum shear stress theory can be written as 0 minus sigma b is equal to sigma yield point. So you will get sigma b is equal to minus sigma yield point. So this is again a equation of straight line. So that is represented by this particular curve. So this is the third curve. So we have case 1 represented by this curve, straight line curve, and case 2, this inclined curve, and case 3, horizontal curve. So similarly, if you plot the curve, okay, for the other three cases, cases in which sigma b is greater than sigma a, you will find three more curves. So these three curves will be obtained. So when you see plot these curves, the bounds, within this bound, the material is safe. So when the stress condition crosses these points, the material has failed. So this is therefore the plot of maximum shear stress theory for 2D stress condition.